The word on every Nigerian's lip today is corruption. The cankerworm stares us in the face everywhere we go. And one begins to wonder, why has corruption become a way of life despite its devastating consequences? Good evening and welcome to the program, The Eagle. My name is Aisha Gambari. Also on the program is Aisha Mohammed.
Hello. Hi, Aisha. Good evening to you, viewers. Thanks for joining us as we bring you another interesting edition of the program.
For me to buy correct motor, for me to take make my door.
He could have been my father or someone else's brother.
Put in place to check the manners of corruption, the increasing rates of corruption indices in our society is becoming very frightening as the perpetrators have become unrepentant. Our reporter was again on the street to find out if value reorientation can play a role in checking the manners. Does the family have a role to play in the fight against corruption? Golden Ago will bring you answers to these in the course of our edition today.
And as a way of enhancing the collaboration between the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, and the United States in the fight against economic and financial crimes, the U.S. Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, donates a forensic workstation to the commission.
We will also bring you a report on the arrest of one Kato Ifrahim Iyam and Godwin Odali, both staff of a New Generation Bank, for conspiring to defraud the bank to the tune of over 3 billion naira.
And still talking about foreign partnership, Kamala Gebi will represent the EFCC's Foreign Partnership Initiative on our special focus segment.
Please stay tuned as the program continues shortly.
EFCC will get you anywhere, anytime.
Welcome back. Despite measures put in place to check the manners of corruption, the increasing rates of corruption indices in our society is becoming very frightening as the perpetrators have become unrepentant. Our reporter Golden Ago was again on the streets to find out if value reorientation can play a role in checking the manners. Her report.
The value the society attaches to a particular virtue goes a long way to determine how far people can go to obtain it. So much importance has been attached to wealth, and this has resulted in people engaging in all kinds of vices to make wealth. Corruption is one of such vices. Can value orientation help check the menace of corruption? Let's find out.
I think the parents should teach their children the right thing. First of all, when they send their children to school, they should let them know that they should study and pass their exams by themselves. That whatever they do, they have to earn it on merit. Because I believe some parents are the ones that allow their children to go into all these corrupt practices, malpractices. They even pay the teachers, you know, buy question papers to allow these children to move further, to move to the next level. And these children, they are assimilating all these things, and they know that their parents are doing this for them, and they can continue with it because what your parents are doing and you are doing it, nobody will caution you about it.
I think the first thing is for the parents to inculcate the right discipline into the life of the children first from the house before then they go out to the society.
Looking at the family unit, what role can the family play in value orientation?
What I see in these things is all about the family, parents. It's the way you brought up your children that they will also move elsewhere, outside. We parents, we need to impact some things in our children. You need to teach them before any other thing.
I am suggesting that we will start from home, because home is the beginning of the whole thing. If you have a good family value, you will not be involved in the violence. You will not be involved in stealing. But because we have lost our family value, that is why Nigeria is going the way they are going.
Me as a father, I have my own way and I have my own principle in my house and my children. The principle that I'm teaching my children, they should learn from my footstep. That's number one. Then they should learn how me and their mother will live together. Because it depends. If you, a father and the mother, they are not living in a way that the children will learn from them, no matter how they do, the children will go astray. Me, my method that I am broadening up my children is different from others. Because I have grown up children, four of them. And I believe, still up to now, the senior one is 27 years. I still beat him up to now, because I don't want him to go mingling with his friend the way that he would do bad things. And they respect me, and they obey me.
This corruption of a thing, if you teach your children how to struggle, how to just don't look what other people are doing that is bad. Just focus attention on what you are doing. Teaching children how to struggle, maybe after education, they will learn, they will do other things to at least to keep life going. The children will not look back. they will know that maybe after secondary school education, either you learn trade or you learn how to sew machine or carpentry work or other things, be contented with what they have. Children will follow suit. But a situation where you parents are not doing anything, tomorrow you bring this one, children will ask questions. Daddy or mommy, where? You say, don't worry. You have to tell your children where you are getting all those things. It's from my shop. It's from this my workshop. It's from this way. Or from a mechanic that we get this one. Children will know that they will have to struggle, fight, learn things, so that tomorrow they will be okay.
I think we are the role model to our children. It starts from the mother. Understand? You as a mother, you have to present yourself in a way that the child will not regret it in life. You understand? You inculcate things in the child that are positive. You don't fight in your child's presence, you understand? There are some things you don't say, like making call, you begin to lie, and your child is there watching. Before you know it, he sees us as a normal thing.
There is a saying that if you train up a child in the way he should go, when he's old, he will not depart from it. It is therefore very important that parents should take responsibility for their ward's upbringing, as the family has been identified as a major player in the fight against corruption. Golden Ago, reporting for the Eagle.
In another development, as a way of enhancing the collaboration between the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, and the United States in the fight against economic and financial crimes, the U.S. Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, donates a forensic workstation to the EFCC. Rolake Odofin Jolayemi has this and other reports.
The equipment, technically referred to as Forensic Recovery of Evidence Device, FRED, was presented to the head of operations, Lagos Zonal Office of the EFCC, Ilyasu Kwabai, by the United States Acting Consul General, Dahab Giriab. According to Giriab, the equipment will enhance the EFCC's efforts in the fight against cybercrime and standardize its operations. The device will also help the EFCC in analyzing, processing, and preservation of digital evidence, which can be presented in courts in a clear, concise, and understandable manner, thereby aiding judges to adjudicate effectively. Kwabai, while receiving the device, thanked the FBI for their support to the Commission in the areas of manpower development and investigation. Giriab, on her part, praised the long-term partnership between the FBI and EFCC, which has existed for more than a decade. She commended the EFCC for its professionalism and encouraged it to keep up the good work. In another development, the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, arraigned the duo of Yezidu Abdullahi and Awal Tahir Aliyu before Justice Rabi Umar of Bauchi State High Court on a 5-count charge bordering on conspiracy, forgery, and obtaining money by false pretense to the tune of over 700,000 naira. The suspects, who are members of a syndicate, allegedly perpetrated the fraud using a forged right of occupancy of a property situated in Fadaman Mada, Bauchi State, and sold the said property to an unsuspecting victim who eventually discovered that the property does not belong to the accused persons as claimed by them. Still on prosecution, the commission also arraigned one Bawa Momodu before Justice I.E. Ekwo of the Federal High Court sitting in Port Harcourt, River State, on a 16-count charge bordering on forgery, uttering, and stealing to the tune of 27 million naira. The petitioner, a New Generation Bank, alleged that Momodu, a former staff of the bank, stole the sum from the account of one of its customers. The accused allegedly forged the signature of the said account holder and fraudulently withdrew the money from the bank. He, however, pleaded not guilty to the charges preferred against him. Justice Ekwo granted the accused person bail in the sum of 7 million naira and one surety in like sum. The surety must be a responsible member of the society with landed property worth the bail sum, to be verified by the court registrar and the prosecution. In a related development, Justice Ekwo has ordered the remand of one Festus Agadi in prison custody till September 23, 2015, when his application for bail would be considered. Agadi was docked by the EFCC on a 1-count charge bordering on obtaining money by false pretense to the tune of 2 million naira. He pleaded not guilty to the charge when it was read against him. The accused, an employee of Petra Services Limited, is alleged to have defrauded the company on the pretext that the money was the cost price of a used Caterpillar excavator engine he has secured for the company. Still on reports, a crack team of operatives of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, have arrested one Kato Ifrahimu Nyam and Godwin Odali, both staff of a New Generation Bank, for conspiring to defraud the bank to the tune of over 3 billion naira with an e-payment mandate purportedly from Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development. The suspects, who operate as a syndicate, sometime in June 2015, through their cronies, submitted an e-payment mandate of over 1 billion naira to Zenith Bank and Access Bank PLC. The banks, sensing foul play on the e-payment mandate, discreetly contacted the Ministry of Agriculture for confirmation and authentication of the document. A response from the ministry showed that no mandate was sent to the banks. Hence, the EFCC was contacted for investigation. While the investigation was underway, the suspects, in furtherance of their dubious acts, submitted another e-payment mandate to Zenith Bank through one Abiola Oloko, an accomplice. In the process, Oloko was arrested by EFCC operatives. Oloko, who claimed to be a job seeker, said he was lured into the business by the bank officials, who he claimed gave him an identity card of the Federal Ministry of Agriculture and Rural Development to answer the false name Femi Babatunde, but with his real passport photograph affixed to it. The suspects will be arraigned in court as soon as investigation into the matter is concluded. Rolake Odofin Jolaemi, reporting for The Eagle.
Cheers, cheers.
I got a telephone call.
Anytime I close my eyes, yes, I see dead people chasing me in my sleep.
My Jehovah, Magada.
Is it possible for someone to become restless just because of his past?
Nevertheless, unless you kill somebody dead, then the spirit will be haunted you.
Hey!
Was you owe contractors?
I embezzled all the money for the roads that are now death traps, killing people every day. I approved the supplies of fake drugs on pipe on water.
I embezzled the money.
I did fear, Chief.
You are supposed to fear, a special man that you don't develop EFCC. I chose people who are doing Uru to trouble other people with money. EFCC, as soon as they capture them, threat to prison here.
Chief, jail.
Jail.
Ah!
How you are? Life is not just about acquiring wealth. Making money. When other people are doing die of hunger and neglect. Be careful. EFCC, I watch.
EFCC will get you anywhere, anytime.
You're still watching the program, The Eagle. The EFCC is not relenting in its efforts to deepen cooperation with international stakeholders in the fight against organized crime. On our lineup today is a special interview which The Eagle crew had with David Keita, a representative of the UK National Crime Agency. He spoke extensively about the synergy between the commission and his agency. Kamilu Gebi represents the report.
The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, has enjoyed tremendous support in the areas of investigation and training of its personnel, among other support from foreign law enforcement agencies. The commission's relationship with these agencies dates back to the time of Nuhu Ribadu as chairman of the EFCC. He was instrumental in establishing relationships with the Federal Bureau of Investigations, FBI, and the London Metropolitan Police, amongst others. These relationships, however, suffered a great setback when he was removed in controversial circumstances in 2007. But in 2012, when Ibrahim Lamorde became the chairman of the EFCC, reforms were initiated and executed to change the way the commission is perceived. Since then, the commission's relationship with international partners has improved dramatically. The direct fallout is fresh windows of support that have come in the form of joint operations, training opportunities, and offer of specialized equipment. Recently, the French embassy in Nigeria, led by the police attaché, Eric Bonichon, donated 8 laptops to the commission as part of its support to strengthening the commission's quest to rid the country of economic and financial crimes. While handing over the laptops, Eric, who spoke through an interpreter, said although the laptops were not enough, The gesture demonstrates the implicit confidence and support of the French government for the EFCC in the fight against corruption in Nigeria.
The embassy of France, we have the honor today to present 8 laptops and 8 mouses to the EFCC. It is not enough, but it is a sign of the improvement of our cooperation.
Apart from the French embassy, the Metropolitan Police also visited the commission. Jonathan Benton, head Proceeds of International Corruption Unit, who led the delegation, said they were at the commission to further strengthen the existing relationship with EFCC in the area of investigation. The Met Police is known to have supported the commission in various investigations, one of which is that of former governor of Delta State, James Ibori, who is serving a 13-year jail term in London.
We have had a long-standing relationship, and I always look forward to meeting Chairman Lamorde, be it this is my first visit to Nigeria, but in many of the international forums that we meet at and discuss corruption cases with our counterparts. We must remember that we can only ever do this together. We can't do it in isolation. The international financial centres do play a part, and London is an international financial centre. The way money flows work and the way money is moved and where people like to buy houses and spend their holidays and send their children to school, London is one of those places in the UK, and we have to accept that. And it is important we play our part in fighting corruption.
In December 2014, the Western Australia Police signed a memorandum of understanding with the EFCC to work together to combat internet fraud and money laundering. This partnership led to the arrest of one Orowo Jesse Omoko, a 28-year-old undergraduate of University of Ibadan, who allegedly obtained the sum of $90,000 from one Jetty Jacob, an Australian based in Johannesburg, South Africa, in a fake romance scam. The victim later died in mysterious circumstances. Other foreign agencies with which the Commission enjoys robust partnership include the Global Fund, US Federal Trade Commission, US Postal Inspection Service, the World Bank, African Development Bank, British Serious Fraud Office, Economic Crimes Network, and Australia Federal Police. The Commission has also signed an agreement for the establishment of the Economic Crime Agency Network, comprising London Police, Corrupt Practices Investigation Bureau of Singapore, European Anti-Fraud Office, Hong Kong's Independent Commission Against Corruption, the US FBI, the Malaysia Anti-Corruption Commission, New Zealand Serious Fraud Office, the Indonesia Corruption Eradication Commission, as well as the UK National Crime Agency. David Cater is with the UK National Crime Agency. He spoke about his agency's collaboration with the EFCC.
We've had a long-standing relationship, which involves mutual support from operations in both the UK and Nigeria, both agencies assisting each other. And that's developed over the years into a relationship which now also includes working on some active projects where NTA is actively supporting EFCC in some specific operations and helping to develop its capability.
How long has this relationship been?
The overall relationship has been running for many years, more than 10 years plus. The current project that I'm referring to has been running for a little over a year. But that's just one small element of a constant ongoing relationship between the two agencies.
Of what benefit is this relationship to both agencies?
The benefit to NTA is that, as you're probably aware, there's quite a lot of crime in Nigeria that impacts on the UK. So we get benefit by working with EFCC to try to investigate some of these criminals and some of the different crime that's impacting on the UK. Hopefully, conversely, EFCC gets benefit from a similar arrangement with us, the UK sharing assistance with criminal intelligence case work, assisting on cases, as well as hopefully benefiting from some of the skills and experience that we can bring to assist in developing the capability of the Commission.
How fruitful has this relationship been?
It's been very fruitful. On a regular basis, we have inquiries, some of which could be quite simple, basic checks that are being done by the UK for you guys at EFCC, and similarly for EFCC for us in the UK.